Hello students,
I am Dr. Tanmoy Bishash. I welcome you all in my channel Chemistry Chemistry of Molecules. So today we will discuss an important topic, that is pyridine N-oxide. So this is an important topic because this creates a lot of exceptional property, or this generates a lot of exceptional properties and exceptional transformation. And this is actually, you may consider it's an intermediate preparation for different functional groups. So today's lecture will encounter a few points like the basic idea and importance, reactivity with respect to pyridine and this compound and its resonance structure, electron density distribution and dipole moment comparison with trithiolamine, and finally aromatic electrophilic substitution and nucleophilic substitution, basic point of view. So in the next video I shall explain the details as example to example specific about this pyridine N-oxide. So let's start. Before going to details, I have a request. If you really like my teaching, please help my channel to grow. Let's start. So if you look at pyridine molecule, so this pyridine molecule versus pyridine N-oxide. So this is the pyridine and this is the pyridine N-oxide. This, by the way, never do this mistake, means this. So this is a wrong. Why? Because the nitrogen have valency 5. So valency 5, that is wrong, not possible. If it is phosphorus, you can write, because they have energetically accessible vacant d orbitals, so they can do. So please don't do this mistake. So actual structure should be written in this way. This is a Zwitterionic structure. Okay. And how this is formed? So first of all, it reacts with glacial acetic acid. Okay. And in presence of 30% hydrogen peroxide. So this is actually a oxidant to the oxidation of pyridine. Okay. See, oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen. So that is the reason it is oxidized. So this is actually the oxidizing agent, and in terms of glacial acetic acid, this is formed. This is actually the pyridine N-oxide. Okay. Since the oxide O- attached to nitrogen, that's why this is called N-oxide. Fine. And interesting point is that this oxygen, this could be useful as intermediate, as because you can regenerate or remove this oxygen by the treatment of some oxygen removal reagent. Okay. So what are those oxygen removal reagent? Like PCl3, CCl2 means carbene, or PPH3. So what happens with them? So this is carbene and this is phosphorus region. So this oxygen in presence of this is converted into POCl3. This is converted into carbonyl chloride, that is phosgene, or this is converted into triphenyl phosphine oxide. Okay, so this is the fate of this region. In this way, this oxygen is removed to regenerate the pyridine moiety. Okay, so what is the importance? So in order to understand the importance, you have to understand the electronic distribution pattern. How? So if you look at the canonical forms, canonical form of this, how? So this, so first of all, see, this is actually a positive charge species. So what can happen? It can neutralize its positive charge, and this positive charge is on an electronegative nitrogen atom. So it could be taken. Please look at this thing very carefully. If you don't understand the resonance, it will be difficult for you to explain this phenomenon. Okay, fine. So positive charge is now here. This, similarly, it can come here. So the positive charge should go here. Similarly, positive charge can go here in this way. Okay, so this is the overall first. Second, another canonical structure possible. How? just look at, let's draw the structure again. This is N plus O minus. This, so this oxygen can form a double bond. So if it is, then it will come here. So negative this, sorry, it should be double bond. There should be. Okay. In next stage, what see, this is positive still, tetravalent. See, next it will come here, it will go. So the canonical form, I suggest you please do practice along with me, otherwise you will not be able to do it. So this again, next step, it can come here, it will come here. Its property is actually dependent on the canonical forms, so it is highly desirable. So what is the conclusion? So see, this structure, so this part indicates that this nucleus is electron rich. Okay, electron rich than pyridine, because negative charge, you can see in case of pyridine, if you see the canonical forms, you can write in this way that this, so nitrogen is electronegative atom, so it can hold the negative charge. So this is plus. Similarly, plus charge will come here. Similarly, plus charge will come here. So these three positions are plus charge. So actually, this is electron deficient. Okay, so it is electron deficient and it is electron rich than pyridine. So that is the reason that it can undergo aromatic electrophilic substitution easily. Okay, I'll count that thing. But this this concept is very important. That's why I'm telling you, please keep it in mind, this canonical form and electron density distribution. Okay, then you will understand how and why this is happening. Now, questions. Now let's go to the, we have discussed the electron density distribution. Okay, and reactivity of this versus with pyridine. So reactivity comparison with pyridine. Now let's discuss about the dipole moment. So what do I mean? Dipole moment, when I say, then I have to compare, and that for that comparison, it is taken triethyl amine, N oxide. If you see, this is O minus, this is N plus. This has higher mu than pyridine N oxide, than this pyridine N oxide. Okay, question 1. The reason is that, see, here the dipole moment act one directional. So this is one directional. Okay, but in this case, if you see, in all these cases, the dipole moment comes in this direction. Here also, here also, here also. Positive charge in this direction, negative charge. But in this form, you can see positive charge is here, negative charge is there. So in the reverse direction, this is. So you can consider that one cancel out another. That's why it has a relatively lesser dipole moment. Please keep this information in mind and try to understand. Such question could be asked in why. Fine. So this is the overall reason for its higher dipole moment. Now let's focus on aromatic electrophilic substitution. Okay, so aromatic electrophilic substitution, and if you focus, then see, pyridine is more electron rich than pyridine N oxide is more electron rich, because better to say not electron rich, that term is quite ambiguous. It can supply electron if needed. So this line is pyridine N oxide can provide electron if needed. That is the reason that it acts as a very, very good substrate for aromatic electrophilic substitution. Why? See, because of this resonance structure, you look at here, the three position, here positive charge density, there, there and there. So aromatic electrophilic substitution means we will react with the electrophile which is electron deficient. So if it is electron deficient, then it will not prefer to add this ortho para position. Instead of that, it will prefer to attack this meta position. So pyridine is always meta directing. So this is meta directing. So let us write here, pyridine is meta directing. Fine. Now what is about the pyridine enox? What about this pyridine enoxide? See, pyridine enoxide, look at these canonical forms. Fine. This canonical form, it can provide electron in ortho para position. This. Now you can say that, sir, positive charge is here also. Then how can you say that? Means why you are focusing on the negative charge? You should counter the positive charge also. Fine. Yes, you are right. But when a aromatic electrophilic substitution happens, the stability of the sigma complex matters. Okay, so please visit my basic concept related video about aromatic electrophilic and nucleophilic substitution for details understanding. You will understand. So the importance is the stability of sigma complex is the most important thing. Now, sigma complex is electron deficient species. So when we are considering with the electron deficient species, it is highly desirable that we should discuss about the electron releasing effect. Why? Let's focus on this molecule, fluorobenzene. So question is, it is electron donating, activating or deactivating? This is deactivating. This is deactivating. It has a minus I or plus I, sorry, minus R or plus, so minus I effect, and along with that, plus R effect, and overall this is deactivating. So when you do aromatic electrophilic substitution, this is ortho para detecting. Fine. Similar story is for this pyridine enoxide. Okay, so what happens if you put any electrophilic species, it will react on the ortho para position. Let me show with respect with some means canonical forms. So if you react this with electrophile, this 4 position could be attacked. So what will be the consequence? This is the enoxide, this plus charge is here. So this is the hydrogen, this is the electrophile. Now, as I told, the stability of the sigma complex is the most important thing. How this is stabilized? By resonance. Fine, in this way. So in next step, this is the hydrogen, this is the electrophile, this and the positive charge comes on the nitrogen. See, positive charge is on nitrogen, it's highly electronegative atom, so this is not stable. Another point of view, there is a O minus, so it can provide, and see, it's a 3 bond, so it can easily give this to and stabilize the charge, this. So actually nitrogen is carrying the positive charge, formal positive charge better to say, but this is not electron deficient because of the oxygen, that is why. Now you can consider that, sir, why you are showing about, why you are mainly focusing para? So this is mainly para directing. Okay, why not ortho? Similar story is possible. See, if you look at pyridine enoxide, so these versus these we are considering. This nitrogen is electronegative atom having carrying a positive charge attached to an electronegative oxygen, so it has a minus I effect, but that minus I effect will not operate at this carbon, but in both case ortho and para, plus R will operate. Okay, so plus R will operate. So that is the reason, in this position, two opposite effect, minus I as well as plus R, here only plus R. So this is more electron discenter. So apparently reaction is expected to happen on this position. By the way, here nucleophilic attack prefers, I'll come later. So fine. So we have understood that why ortho attack happens on this position. Okay, fine. Because of the stabilization of the intermediate. Now,
let's discuss about aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Okay, so as I told, pyridine is an electron deficient nucleus. Electron deficient means it is as much as electron deficient like nitrobenzene. Okay, so if it is electron deficient like nitrobenzene, then expected that nitrobenzene undergo very easily aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Okay, so this pyridine enoxide will, for example, you may consider that this is nitrobenzene. Okay, let me remove this part. This is pyridine and this is nitrobenzene. Okay, this is 4-chloro-nitrobenzene. If you react this with alkali, what is expected? Alkali will attack. Ultimately, this will come and come back, and ultimately it will leave. So what will be the product? Please visit the basic concept of aromatic nucleophilic substitution for your better understanding. I am not explaining everything in details here. And if you take 4-chloropyridine, similar thing happens. Its reactivity pattern is similar, and ultimately it results in 4-hydroxypyridine. Okay. From this thing, you have understood that reactivity pattern, pyridine is prone to electron nucleophilic, aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Now, question, what about this enoxide? What unique behavior it can do? For example, if you take, let me clean this one. If you take mix acid and react with pyridine enoxide, means mix acid like nitric, means nitric acid, sulfuric acid. So, in presence of nitric acid, nitration occurs at 4 position. 4-nitropyridine enoxide. Fine. We know it's para-directing. Fine. And if you treat this with benzyl alcohols, alkoxide, it attacks and similarly. How? First it comes here, then it comes, then means charge is neutralized, then it come back. Okay, let me show the step. So this is OBZ, benzylic. So this part CH2 is benzylic. So this is the N, O minus, negative charge is neutralized. Now in next step it pushes, it come back, it removes. So what is the final product? This, and along with this, N oxide. And for this process, urea is used. Okay, why urea consumes this NO2 minus, this leaves. So this group leaves, so urea is used to quench the temperatures. Fine. Now, so this is the aromatic nucleophilic substitution. Now, question we have discussed about this. Fine, it's a substituted derivative. If we take a simple pyridine enoxide, what will be the consequence? So, if you take this pyridine enoxide, this, and you put a nucleophile, where this nucleophile will attack? Okay, so this nucleophile will attack here. Why? Just look at carefully. Look at carefully. Carefully means, see this part. You may resemble this with respect to a protonated keto version. Okay, carbonyl. So, it will attack similarly. And if you draw the canonical form, positive charge will come here as this thing I have explained previously. So, positive charge will come. Now, positive charge comes to para position also. But, nucleophilic substitution means electron rich species will attack. So, where it will attack? That place which is maximum electron deficient. So, if you compare the maximum electron deficiency, this position, these ortho positions are maximum electron deficient. That's why they are. For example, if you take Grignard reagent, PhMgBr, what happens? So, first this pH minus attacks. I will explain later on some example. This is N this plus charge will be quenched, this O minus, and this is hydrogen, this is pH. In, by the way, there is a famous name reaction, Chichibabin reaction, which I will explain in some next videos. So, after that we know that Grignard reaction means anhydrous ether we will do, and after that work up. Work up means dilute acid, so what will happen? This will be protonated, OH. So, another thing, after protonation, since this lone pair and this lone pair has a repulsion, so it undergo protonation very easily. This is the alpha effect kind of phenomena. So these, and if it leaves, then in order to balance electron deficiency, this proton will also leave. And ultimately what it will result? It will result two substituted pyridine derivative. So this is another interesting point. So from here, what you can get? From here, let me clean. So from this benzyl derivative, what you can get, you can remove this oxygen by this phosphorus reagent. So removal of oxygen. So what you will get? This pyridine 4 benzylic. So for 4 substitution, this is good. For 2 substitution, this is good. And then question comes, if you want to substitute 3, take simple pyridine because it's a metadirectine. For example, sulfonation if you do, or nitration you will do, you will get the 3 substitution. So this is the overall discussion, how to get different substituted pyridine. For orthopara means 2 or 4, it is better to go through the inoxide pathway, and for meta, you have to use the pyridine. Okay, so this is the overall discussion for today. So what we have discussed, what you have learned, we have first learned about the basic property and preparation process of pyridine N-oxide using this hydrogen peroxide. Second, its reactivity pattern is changed because of electron delocalization, and in case of simple pyridine, which is a metadirectine, this pyridine N-oxide is an orthoparadirectine. For aromatic electrophilic substitution, it prefers to happen on the 4 position. Aromatic nucleophilic substitution is preferred to happen on the 2 position because of the presence of electronegative atom, means minus I as well as plus I effect. And finally, we have learned how to get 2 had substituted, 3 substituted, and 4, 5 substituted pyridine, substituted pyridine derivative. So, this is the end of this discussion. In next video, I shall discuss some specific reaction. I believe those are very important for you. I don't want to make the video unnecessarily lengthy, that's why I'm splitting. So, thank you again. Thanks for watching. If you really like my teaching, please help my channel to grow. First of all, subscribe my channel Chemistry and Mystery of Molecule, and please press the bell icon to get the notification of every single video I upload. Secondly, share this video among your friends so that many people could be benefited, and I shall be satisfied, and indirectly it will help my channel to grow its reputation. And most importantly, please like the video and inspires me to make new videos for you. So thank you again. Stay happy, stay blessed. See you in my next video.